Hi friends, I'm Dr. Saurabh Sharma. Let's discuss on ophthalmology questions in EQ based on next pattern and clinical questions. Okay, let us read the question. A 45-year-old patient working in a metallic industry presented with difficulty to see near objects from his one eye and left eye. Okay, there was a history of trauma to the right eye 2 months back for which an eye surgery was done. The doctor noticed the following findings. The visual acuity was slightly less, 6 by 12 is slightly less, interpolation is normal. Okay, this is normal in 10 to 21 millimeters is normal. Anterior chamber, there were few cells and few deposits on the corneal endothelium. What is the deposition in corneal endothelium known as? Keratic precipitates. And on retina, fundus examination, multiple choroidal infiltrates are there. What is the likely diagnosis? So to understand this question, what is happening? There are some vital words which are important here is metallic industry, patient working metallic industry, difficulty in near vision, history of trauma to the other eye, right eye. 2 months back, recently, visual acuity is less, and as I showed you, these are the signs. What is the likely diagnosis? It's a very classical presentation. If the right eye is having some trauma and it have involved the uveal tissue of the other eye, uveal tissue of this eye, the body desensitizes and the other eye is having some changes now. Other eye is having difficulty in near vision, loss of accommodation, and there is some uveitis in the other eye. So the other eye becomes sympathizing eye. This is a classical presentation of sympathetic ophthalmia. Presbyopia, also there is difficulty in near vision, but in presbyopia you will get these inflammatory cells. This only after 40 years of age. It's a physiology that after 40 years the accommodation decreases and there is decrease in the near vision. That is presbyopia. So that is of course not the answer. Wogt-Kiange-Herodes syndrome, in which the patient has some systemic features as well, like poliosis, tinnitus, sensorineural deafness, and the features are similar to sympathetic ophthalmia, but there is no history of trauma in Wogt-Kiange-Herodes. In toxoplasmosis, there is no history of trauma and there is a headlight in fog, single choroidal infiltrate with a lot of vitreous inflammation. That's the most common cause of posterior uveitis, but this is not the presentation. There is no history of trauma. There is a history of pet cat with toxoplasmosis. So, sympathetic ophthalmia, there has to be a penetrating trauma, either penetrating trauma. So, that's why this is important, right? Metallic industry, he might be working in some iron, metallic, and iron is the most common intraocular foreign body going inside the eye, causing penetrating trauma involving the uveal tissue. Most common antigen involved is retinal antigen. The body, this is lost. This eye is lost maybe because of trauma. Surgery was done to maybe for perforation. Something is going inside, you have to perforate, you have to seal. So this eye operation was done two months back. The body recognized the uveal tissue. Most common antigen, retinal antigen, and the immunity of the body. Other eye also has uveal tissue, right? So immunity acts against the uveal tissue of the other eye. So the other eye also gets a uveitis, granulomatous panuveitis. There were cells in the anterior chamber. It's a panuveitis. And posterior choroid were also having some infiltrate. So it's a panuveitis. There were KPs, mutton fat KPs might be there in granulomatous disorders. Most commonly, it involves a ciliary body. Okay. This is exciting eye. This becomes sympathizing eye. And the maximum chances of getting the sympathizing eye is 2 weeks to 3 months. It can happen lifelong after trauma. But 65% chance is between 2 weeks to 3 months. That was the patient presenting in 2 months time here. It involves a ciliary body. That is why ciliary body is important in the eye for near vision. That was the first symptom in the other eye, loss of near vision or loss of accommodation. The retinal flare can be first sign. Some nodules can be there under the retina, Dahlen-Fuge nodules, and we have to treat by intravenous steroids. Just to show, these are some granulomatous under the, this is cornea slit lamp light at the level of cornea, under the cornea. This picture is slightly difficult to say. There is a mutton fat keratic precipitates, granulomatous uveitis, there are choroidal, multiple, these white are multiple choroidal infiltrates. When they settle down, multiple choroidal infiltrates settle down, the fundus looks like a sunset glow fundus. Sunset glow fundus can be seen in sympathetic ophthalmia. And I told you, Wogt-Kiange-Herodes and sympathetic, both are panuveitis, granulomatous, both can have this multiple choroidal infiltrates, sunset glow fundus. But Wogt-Kiange-Herodes has systemic features, poliosis, tinnitus, and there's no history of trauma. Sympathetic ophthalmia is after penetrating trauma, or anything which is going inside the eye involving the uveal tissue, like complicated cataract surgeries, complicated glaucoma surgeries, complicated ocular surgeries. So that is also caused, but the most important cause is penetrating trauma. Okay, so that was the answer to today's EQ, sympathetic ophthalmia. Thank you for listening. Best of luck.